Clarendon Learning explores types of government. Have you ever thought what it would be like to be the President of the United States? Or what it would be like to be a king? What if you ruled the world? What kind of ruler would you be? Could you live in a country where one person made all the rules and laws and declared with an iron fist?
My way or the only way?
Would you rather live in a country where citizens had a say or a vote in who their leaders are and how they would be governed? Or maybe you would prefer to live in a country with no rules, no laws, where everyone could do as they pleased. A land of unbridled freedom. Does that sound good to you? Could such a world even exist? This is a very big world with billions of people. People of different cultures and different ideas of how to govern and how they want to be governed. A government is the system of rules and laws and policies used to direct a neighborhood, a city, a state, or a nation. From the beginning, when people began to live in tribes or villages or towns, for the people to prosper and live in peace, there had to be a system to create a balance and order in the community. Someone needed to be in charge. Someone needed to establish a set of rules. In a family, the person in charge might have been a parent or a grandparent. As families gathered to make communities and work to make their communities successful, there needed to be some rules to follow. Rules assuring security, protection, and liberty. Sometimes the leader was the biggest and the meanest and the toughest. Sometimes the leader was the oldest. And sometimes the leader was the smartest and wisest. Sometimes the leader was chosen by the voice and vote of the people. And sometimes a leader just elected himself. Okay, now it's time to think about it. What do you think it takes to be a good leader? Consider the following. Should a leader be the strongest person? Should a leader be the most popular? Should a leader be a person who has the best ideas? Throughout history, government leaders have been called kings, queens, rulers, monarchs, chiefs, heads of state, general secretaries, emperors, presidents, prime ministers, parliamentarians, senators, or representatives. Today in the world, there are 195 countries with a total population of about 7.7 billion people. I think it's doubtful that all these people could agree on one type of government, don't you? Cultures and customs and natural resources and education and even religion, all of these things affect the kind of government that a country will develop and tolerate. Let's look at some of the significant types of government structures and some of the countries that are ruled by them.
Make way for His Majesty the King! Your wish is my command, Your Royal Highness.
You may hear phrases like this in a country led by a monarchy. In a monarchy, a king or a queen rules and makes all major decisions. The power of the kingdom is inherited and generally passes to the firstborn child. When you think of a country being led by a queen, what's the first country that comes to your mind? Could it be, maybe England? Yep, England. England has a monarchy, and the head of the state is Queen Elizabeth II. However, her actual power is mostly symbolic, and despite all the glitz and glamour and pomp and drama of the royal family, the real power of England lies in its parliamentary democracy, a prime minister. And the parliament is made up of the House of Lords and House of Commons. These are the guys that really hammer out the legislation and laws. The people of the United Kingdom enjoy a high degree of liberty and freedom. An example of an absolute monarchy would be the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, ruled by King Salman and his word as it complies with the religion of Islam, is the law. And the people have very little or no influence or vote or voice in how the country is governed. As with many countries, ruled under a monarchy, the royal family lives a life of luxury, while much of the rest of the country lives in poverty. With that, we are going to gently segue into another government type, a theocracy, which, based on religion, recognizes a god or supreme being as the ultimate authority, and the affairs of the country are administered by a religious leader. For example, the Islamic nation of Iran, the supreme leader applies Sharia law, and strict obedience is required by everyone, with severe penalties for disobedience. The smallest independent region in the world run as a theocracy, with a population of only 1,000 people, is the Vatican City, Rome. Its affairs are administered by the Pope, who presides over the Catholic Church worldwide. Another type of government, under which the people have very little freedom and are the most oppressed, is called a dictatorship. Dictators rule with absolute power. In many cases, dictators gain power through violence. They protect themselves with the military and instill fear in the people. Often, a dictator is removed by force, only to be replaced with another dictator. History is full of dictators. One you may have heard of is Adolf Hitler. Hitler led Nazi Germany during World War II and was responsible for the Holocaust. Another country which you may be familiar with and is closer to the United States is Venezuela. Today, the people of Venezuela suffer from the lack of food and everyday necessities under a dictator form of government. We've said some pretty complex words like monarchy, theocracy, and dictatorship. Well, here's another one. Totalitarianism. A totalitarian government, like the government of North Korea, is like a dictatorship, with only one political party, and dissent is not tolerated. You cannot vote nor act against the government, and if you do, there are serious consequences, like forever imprisonment, or worse. Now, at this point, you may think that you'd rather live in a country where you could just make up your own rules and laws and have no regulations and do whatever. Is that what you're thinking? Well, Somalia is an example of a country where there is no central government. This is a condition called anarchy. Lawlessness and crime run rampant. It is a land of confusion. Disease is high. The people are poorly educated. They live in extreme poverty. Clans are formed among the people to try and protect themselves. Even with assistance from other countries, it will be challenging for Somalia to recover. In the United States of America, we have a democratic republic. In a democratic republic, we vote for our own government leaders, and we consent to be governed. We have a president and a Congress to enact laws that hopefully improve our country. And if there are leaders that we don't like, we can vote for someone else. We have a Constitution of the United States and a Bill of Rights that protect our fundamental human rights. We work and pay taxes and live by the rule of law. And for this reason, many people want to come here and live the American dream. Hey, it's not perfect, but it isn't half bad. In President Lincoln's Gettysburg Address, he declared that it was his hope that this government of the people, by the people, and for the people shall not perish from the earth. In modern times, governing has become much more complex and challenging as nations decide how to serve their citizens, how to provide for the general welfare, how to protect them and educate them. Perhaps you might be someone to become a mayor or governor or even president. What are some of your ideas to make this world a better place to live?
Thanks for following Clarendon Learning. Be sure to subscribe. For more free resources, check us out at clarendonlearning.org.